Hello everybody, what's up you guys? Welcome to a new episode of DIYRC. In today's episode we are going to talk about the Taranis X9 Lite and how to set the FAILSAFE.
Welcome to
FATX. We already showed you how to bind it with the XM receiver and how to flash the radio with D16 and OpenTX. Now we have to set the FAILSAFE. Because every time I'm tuning on my radio, I'm getting the FAILSAFE warning that I have not set the FAILSAFE yet. And I want to fly the Cinebee 75HD whoop from iFlight, and of course you cannot do that without setting the failsafe. Of course, that comes with an XM receiver in the back, and the X series you can set those failsafe in the radio. You don't have to put it in BETAFLIGHT or use that awful button to set the failsafe. You can, and I'll be showing it later if you're using PPM or something else than SBUS. Let's show you how to set it into the radio. And we just click on buy, and we go into the model, short click to Cinebee, then we go to the second page and we go to down, all the way down, and here you find failsafe, not set yet. And we have several options. You can set it to hold. There's a bad option. We can set it to custom if you're flying an airplane. You can set if the signal connection is lost. So you can set the servos to turn a little bit to the left, and it makes a small circle where it will be landing nearby instead of flying away from you. But we want to be setting it to no pulse. So it will be sending no pulses, no signals to the receiver, and it will just drop out of the air if you set it correct in BETAFLIGHT. So let's go into BETAFLIGHT and connect up the drone. If everything is correct, you get this screen from setup, and then you go down the list and you find failsafe. If you don't find failsafe, then you probably have expert mode off. So you go onto the top and enable expert mode. And then you can find failsafe. And go into failsafe. And here you find failsafe switch, stage 1. And there's a stage 2. So there's some room if you got a small glitch and just a very small disconnect. You got 0.4 seconds for the receiver to reconnect. And if that happens, then you want to have to set the throttle to hold, so it can hold the throttle at the last signal it was given, so it won't tumble into the ground as soon as the first failsafe is activated. It will still happen in stage 2 of the failsafe, but there is a small chance, this is just a small glitch, and that only failsafe stage 1 will be activated, and then you will still have the chance to save the drone. So set the throttle to hold instead of auto. So you want to set it to hold. And of course then this is the aux on for the arming, and then angle mode, horizon mode, and the flip after a crash. And it will be all standing on hold. And if you want to set more switches, then you can. And then we got here, we got the drop. I always choose the drop. If stage 2 is activated, I want the drone to fall straight out of the air, so it doesn't gonna hover a long distance where I have no control over it. With landing, I want to have a drop. This is the safest, and you just have to be flying over safe places instead of landing, because then you have no control and maybe you can hurt somebody. You don't know. So safest way is just for drop. And if you have GPS on your drone, then it's nice to have it to return to home, but you have to set it up if you don't have that. And the iFlight Cinebee 75HD doesn't have GPS. It's too small, sadly enough. So we're just gonna keep it at drop, and that's actually it. You're now ready and done. Now you just have to check the drone and get it to fly and see if the failsafe works. Well, not quite ready to fly at least. For that we have to do a few more things. There will be the next upcoming video. At least for now we have set the failsafe. And now we turn on the radio.
Welcome to OpenTX. Switch warning.
You get a switch warning, but not a failsafe warning anymore. And when we get it ready to fly, it's safe to fly. Safety first. I want to thank you all for watching. And for everybody that was new to this channel, I hope you subscribe. And give this video, of course, a like. And if you have any questions, then leave it down below in the comments and I will get back to you. This is DIYRC, signing out.